Mike, today for your garden, it doesn't seem fair. Look at this. This is Linda Vodder's lush green garden. It looks like it should be outside in a cottage in England, and it's definitely been featured in national magazines because that is gorgeous, and she planted that all on her own. I don't know how you did that. But the truth is, though, you're very choosy about which shrubs go into your garden.
I am, and you know what? I'm going to be choosy for you today.
Thank you.
Because, as always, we were visiting about your garden beforehand, mm-hmm. and you were telling me that you had some pots around your pool, and they're in full sun. And
well, I don't have a pool, but I like that story
okay,
better.
I think
My porch.
Your porch? Maybe that was wishful thinking. A Freudian slip.
Yes.
But if they're out in full sun, like uh-huh. a pool scape would be, then they really need tough plants that can handle the tough conditions that mm-hmm. Oklahoma can throw at them. And you were saying that you had some Japanese hollies or something like that in the pots. They did not do very well, and you need something that can give you that same look, but that's a lot tougher.
Preferably evergreen, so
preferably
it doesn't lose
evergreen.
Its leaves.
So let's go over some options of really tough shrubs that are both evergreen and deciduous.
Okay.
Okay. So this is one of my very new favorites. I've got it everywhere in my garden. It's called Sunshine Ligustrum.
Right.
You can clip it. It looks, it's got a leaf form that's not unlike a boxwood, so you can clip it into traditional boxwood shapes. Mm-hmm. It makes great topiary, and it the color is just really vibrant in the summer. And unlike some plants, some chartreuse plants that kind of revert to the green in the summer, this doesn't. It stays this golden, really
beautiful
hue the entire mm-hmm. summer. And it can take the heat. Okay, another option that we were talking, and I think the one that might be ideal for you, is to use a plant called cotoneester. And if that's hard for people to remember, you can just remember cotton ester. And it has a boxwood leaf also, but it has this more cascading form that kind of arches out over the pots or out of your flower beds, but it's pretty tough. It will put on some berries, but in my case, in my garden, the birds usually eat them up before I can really enjoy them.
Mm-hmm.
But it's beautiful and it's tough.
Okay.
Then you can go on to, I think, a plant that is a little too maligned for how much it can do for the garden. There are so many new varieties of it out now, and that is your classic barberry.
Mm-hmm.
Now, we're familiar with red pygmy barberry, which is a dwarf thorn with the thorns. A lot of people don't like it because it can tend to get woody and it has those little prickles on it. But really, that's so easy to take care of. All you have to do in the early part of spring is give it a hard shear. Just cut it back hard.
Okay.
And then the new growth, feel that, the new soft growth that
oh,
it
yeah.
puts out isn't woody, it isn't prickly.
That's nice.
And it also lends itself to a lot more density in the foliage and the canopy. There are beautiful golden varieties as well.
That's beautiful.
I love it.
We have one more minute, so let's go through these others.
Okay, abelia. This is a beautiful form of plant mm-hmm. that can be either variegated or a solid form. The classic southern plant is a crepe myrtle. It looks gorgeous, especially
yes.
in the fall. And then as another large category, don't overlook the viburnums. They are absolutely beautiful. They're tough. A lot of them bloom beautifully in the spring. Their form in the wintertime is even beautiful. And look at that glossy foliage that some of them put out.
That's
in the
beautiful.
Summertime.
You're right.
Yeah. Lots of different options.
Okay. So for evergreens, we have the juniper, the holly, and then the one that's hard to pronounce that you said I'll like
yeah,
best.
Yeah, the cotoneester. This is the one here. You take that home with you as inspiration. You can take it to the
I'll take it to the store.
Take it to the nursery and say, I want some
yes,
of this.
That's exactly what I'm going to do.
Yeah, it's a
Thank
great
you
idea.
So much.
Sure.
We're so glad you're here. And Linda has a worldwide following on Instagram. You need to go there for her gardening tips and tricks, and you can follow her there or at lindavodder.com. Thanks, Linda.
Sure.